Good morning. Good morning. Yeah. I'm back in the game. yeah, so update. Thank you for watching if you're still watching. So much stuff has happened in the past few days. Well, not really like a lot of stuff, like in the external sense, but in my soul. But yeah, as you saw like in the last video, I think I wasn't doing well, but I did something different, which is like whenever I'm like not feeling good, I think my natural tendency is to isolate and enter into this like hermit like bubble where I just like don't interact with people very much. And in fairness, I hadn't left my house until yesterday. Since Tuesday, I think. So I was like in my home for 2 days straight.
No, don't do it!
Okay, so in the past, Father Guard. In the past 2 days, I have been feeling really down, but I did something different, which is like I reached out to my friends. I have friends like in Germany, here in America, and in Botswana and Nigeria, and I like reached out to them and I was like, oh my god, I think I'm gonna lose it, and they were just like, you need to calm down, okay? But yeah, it's been really good to be able, so that's like a different thing than what I used to do, which is just like kind of like huddle up and allow my like own thoughts to like be at the center of things. But I found that like, you know, I feel like there's a lot of emphasis in self-care on like individual will, like what you by yourself can do for yourself. Which is obviously like what's gonna happen if we're like, you know, like in this hyper-individualistic like late stage capitalism place where like you can self-actualize and you can like fix yourself, etc. Which I think has its merits, for sure. You know, it does give people like responsibility, I guess. But I found that staying in touch with people, like calling friends, you know, cultivating friendships where you can be like super honest with someone and tell them like, oh yeah, I feel like the fundamental meaning of life is questionable, or something like, you can be like as dramatic or as like understated as you want, and you have friends that you can talk to. So that was fun. So it's been good talking to my friends. What else? Oh, I've gotten from like page 1 to page 8 in my short story, and it's like wild. It's getting like, it's taking such an interesting turn, like such a, it's funny when you start something and you think you know what the story is. And I thought I knew, I thought it was gonna be like a story about two girls who are like super close and like, you know, one of them is from a different place and they're like trying to get to know each other or whatever, but that's not what the story is. At all, Father Guard. So that's been really interesting to see that development take place. It really does like remind me that writing isn't, I don't know, it's really, it's, there's really something divine about it, at least for me. Like the idea that you start off with something and then it takes this weird like turn. Yeah, so that's good. And then as for, oh, I taught on Tuesday and it was really good. I taught my students, what did I teach them? Oh, the importance of having specificity in a story. Like, why you need to have real things. Because, like, I think as young writers or people who start to write, I think subconsciously what we do is we push a lot of buttons that everyone has installed in common. Does that make sense? So, like, for example, if you write about someone losing a parent, like everyone has a parent or had a parent or knows what a parent is and knows that you're supposed to feel sad. So if you keep it just like that sentence, at like at that level of this like generic parent figure and this generic child figure, like, you know, it's like, you know, we're supposed to feel sad, right? But the key to like good fiction where you're like, damn, X person died, I can't even fathom, is specificity. Because like you need to make the character real, and you make the character real by having them have specific tastes, specific habits, because we all have little strangenesses, you know, specific fears, specific tendencies, like specific. And the thing is, often when you say specific, people think you mean like describe how they look, like she was 5'4" and like blah, blah, blah. But it's like, not necessarily. What I mean is like, what does it mean to this specific character that their specific mother or father is ill? What does that mean to them? Does it mean that they're losing not just like a parent who used to sign your papers, but like someone who was your cheerleader, or someone who was your best friend, or someone who helped you buy your first bra and like told and took you to the movies, you know, just like specific rituals and specific things that this one mother or this one character did in the world. Or it could be like also complicated, like when you think of this mom, you think of the person who calls you every Sunday and is like, bitch, why didn't you lose weight, or something, like, you know what I'm saying, like. But it needs to be specific, right? And yeah, so I think there's space there for like having like a real emotional connection by making it. Wait, come on. Where are you even? Come here. You're very naughty.
And such a naughty cat. Silly cat.
Yeah, so yeah, specificity. So the way that I kind of put it at the end is like as a reader, I know this is kind of like an exaggeration, but as a reader, if your story is about like someone losing a parent, I need to lose that parent too. And I don't mean like lose my parent, I mean I need to lose that person. Like that person needs to be so real that I'm like, damn, like this woman who collects broken blue plates is like gone from the world. Like, you know, that specific set of things that she brought to the world is like gone now. You know what I mean? So it shouldn't just be like, I'm sad because it's your mom, but I'm sad because he's like all these associations that I have with that character. Does that make sense?
All right, so this is the video for today, or for Thursday, and then please ask me questions for my next video. You know, my Friday video is me answering a bunch of internet questions. And if I don't get questions, then I'll just like find a random question generator. I don't know. But thank you for watching. Yay.